Hey guys, it's Andre from the High Performance Academy. We're here at SEMA with Matt from Heltec, and Matt's here to talk to us a bit about their brand new Elite range of ECUs. So Matt, what is the Elite ECU and how is that different from your existing Platinum series?
Well, it's really our next generation of ECU. So faster processor, more inputs, more outputs, more data logging, more flexible. So it's really the next step, the next generation. It's the ECU to take us, I guess, into the next couple of years. A lot more vehicle applications for this, things like drive-by-wire vehicles, quad variable cam timing, that sort of thing that in our Sport Series ECU probably lacked. We're putting all the technology into the Elite Series here. So it's just an evolution. Continuing on, we're always doing R&D, always new products. So this is the next one in the series, in the family.
Okay, so cars are getting more and more complicated these days, particularly with the advent of CAN bus. How's that making life difficult for an ECU manufacturer like Heltec?
That's a really good question. For those that don't know, the CAN bus is basically a communication protocol. All the different modules within the vehicle talk to each other via this communication. And so every manufacturer does things slightly differently. So at BMW, they talk with a different set of protocols to, say, Toyota or Nissan. And so for us, we have to interface with more and more complex vehicles. They have more and more different systems in them. You take one out, you break the link somewhere, and everything kind of goes a little bit haywire. You take out the heated seats, and suddenly the mirrors might not work, or you take out the RPM, and now the transmission doesn't shift. And so that's something that we have to think about when we're designing these programmable systems. And so with the Elite Series, we do have multiple CAN buses on there, and that actually allows us to communicate not just with our own system. So we offer an expansion system. You know, you can use EGTs or RacePack Dash, and that's all on the Heltec CAN system. Well, this system here has multiple CAN buses, so you can also communicate with the factory CAN bus. So things like your transmission can continue to still work, or ABS or traction or whatever it happens to be. If it's something in the factory ECU that needs to communicate via CAN, then we can continue to do that while also taking full control over the engine. So it's a challenge because you have to know a lot about the OEM information. But with that said, it's getting the job done for the newer vehicles, which, you know, we don't all necessarily want to be driving old hot rods. Now, a lot of us want to modify newer vehicles. We still want to have our AC, and we still want the engine to idle nicely, but we also want to make 1,200 horsepower. So to do that, you need this technology, and that's part of the reason why we're going to this Elite Series ECU, because we do have a lot more flexibility in things just like that.
So with the CAN bus, the multiple CAN buses on the Elite, I'm guessing from what you've just said there, that's going to give you the ability to provide support and plug-and-play models potentially for the newer generation of cars that are coming out now?
Yeah, that's definitely in the future. For now, the Elite Series will be a generic standalone version. We already have our Pro Series of ECUs which do plug in and communicate with the factory CAN buses. So for example, our Nissan 350Z, I'm in America now, so I can say Nissan, but Nissan for the other side of the equator, 350Z or 350Z, that communicates on the factory CAN bus as well. And it's already a plug-in. So actually, the plug-ins tend to be a little easier because, you know, it plugs directly into the OEM harness. You know, there isn't a mismatch of things there. What is actually more difficult is the standalone stuff where it could be going into any number of vehicles. So the plug-ins are actually a little bit easier.
Just while you talk about your Platinum series and the Pro plugins, now just to clear up, these are still going to run, this line of computers is still going to run in conjunction with the Elite. The Elite is not replacing them, that's correct?
Yeah, that's right. We already have multiple ranges of ECUs. We have Sport, Sprint, Pro, and now we'll have Elite. So it's another whole family of ECUs.
Now, with modern cars, I know the Elite has quite a lot of flexibility with inputs and outputs. With modern cars, you're using more and more of these. How important is it to up the ante with this new Elite series?
Yeah, it's you look at the spec sheets of the ECUs that are out there now, and they're just getting longer and longer and longer. It's a laundry list of features. So obviously, that's something that we've looked at, and we sit down with our R&D team and we say, okay, what are the limitations that we have? And one of the limitations is just how many pins you've got on a connector. So that's one limitation. On the other hand, we look at, okay, what can we do with all these pins? We've crammed as much as we can into the box. We also have our CAN expansion modules, which actually allows you to expand the number of inputs and outputs external to the box when you run out of pins on the box. So that's something that we've thought about. It's always a challenge, but being a waterproof case, waterproof connector. There's actually only so many waterproof systems out there, waterproof connectors out there. We also stuck with that the existing connect that we ran with the Sport Series for a few reasons. A, that's a really good, robust, waterproof connector. The pins are easy to get in and out and move around. And we wanted to stick with a similar wiring setup so that our existing customers, if they wanted to upgrade to an Elite, they could just unplug that Sport unit, plug the Elite in, and it would be a turnkey pin-to-pin application. So that's it's an interesting question. We've got to look at a lot of things to say, okay, well, we've got a next-generation EVCUs. Do you make a break from what you've done before, or do you try and make it backward compatible? We're going to try and make things as compatible as possible because we know that, you know, customers do like to upgrade, and we want to make that as easy as possible for those guys to stay with Haltech.
In terms of those upgrading from an existing ECU, with the Elite, are you on a whole new platform in terms of a user interface, the software to actually tune it?
Yeah, it is. A whole new software package. I know a lot of guys will be worried about that, but don't worry. From an end user perspective, I guess it's a little bit more like going from, I don't know, Windows XP to Windows 7. Okay, so yeah, it's totally different in the back end. But from a front end perspective, it looks very similar. The software is still very user friendly. It's very easy to do. But of course, there's more features, there's more functions, it does more. So it is a totally new platform. It communicates at a much faster rate. That's one thing that a lot of people will be happy about. The communication's about 10 times faster than the existing. For things like data logging, getting data logs out of the ECU, that's a huge benefit. And so it is a new software package, but from an end user perspective, it looks very, very similar.
Now, you touched briefly on the new case and the fact it's waterproof. Obviously, this case is a complete change from your existing extruded aluminium cases. What was the sort of the design idea behind that? Why did you decide waterproof was a requirement?
There's a number of reasons. Obviously, something as simple as, well, we've got applications that require a waterproof case. You know, things like jet skis, boats, they're all fuel injected these days. And there's a lot of modifying happening there. So you think, okay, we've got to do something for these guys. If you're going to put the time and the effort and the development into producing a waterproof case for that, well, why not make it waterproof for everybody? The other thing is for engine bay mounted ECUs. A lot more ECUs are getting mounted in that engine bay. Off-road vehicles, even rally and road vehicles, you know, these guys have very little waterproofing. They may be, certainly for a rally vehicle or an off-road vehicle, when you wash it down, just get out that power washer, you power wash everything. So being able to go waterproof on everything, It doesn't limit the people that want to put it into the passenger compartment, but for those that want to put it outdoor, they can. And so we thought, you know what, why not?
When you say waterproof, are we talking just a splash of water, or are we talking it can go underwater?
Yeah, it's pretty much underwater. We've been running this thing in-house. We put it in a fish tank. It's not deep, you know, it's probably half a meter deep. We've run that thing for about 11 hours underwater without a drop coming in. So that's pretty good.
What did the fish think of that?
You know, the fish like it. They swim around it. Like, oh, this is cool.
Good to know. Okay, Matt, we know that the product's being promoted here at SEMA. When can consumers expect it on the shelves?
We should be seeing it on the shelves at a retail level by around the end of February. Exact release date is not out there yet. That depends on a lot of our testing, our training for our dealer network. So our dealers will obviously see it, but before that, we'll be running some dealer training. Beta testing through our dealer network will happen before that. We've already got engines running. So we're hoping for an end of February kind of release to the public.
Oh, it's a great product. I can't wait to see it on an engine. Thanks for taking the time to chat to us.
Not a problem. Thanks for having us.
For online tuning courses, visit learntotune.com.